Two Rivers Psychiatric Hospital had 105 patient beds. That means over 5,100 people a year will have to find other places to go in a system already stretched beyond capacity.
Kind of doing more with less. When I get to the calls, there's always something bad has happened, you know.
Sergeant Sean Hess is a Kansas City, Missouri police officer. He and the other officers responding to calls have been forced to take on the burden of being the first responders in the increasing mental health crisis. Sergeant Hess heads up the crisis intervention team, officers who deal with people suffering from mental illness. He and his team worked closely with Two Rivers Hospital. It was the main place they took people in crisis.
Just make it more difficult. You know, we're already stretched thin on handling calls with people in emotional crisis situation, and you're just taking some of the resources that we have and availability, and it's just going to overburden the emergency rooms is what it's going to do.
In fact, over the past decade, we know that emergency department visits involving mental or behavioral health issues have increased over 60%. So a pretty dramatic increase in patients who are seeking care where access may be difficult.
Chris Reuter is the COO at KU Hospital. The dramatic increase in patients seeking care who have trouble accessing it is putting a strain on his and other metro emergency rooms. It costs, on average, $2,000 an hour for a person suffering from mental illness to take up an ER bed. Hospitals must keep those patients until they're stable or placed in a mental health facility.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, as we sit here today, how hard is it on a scale of 1 to 10 to place somebody?
Well, I think we probably can find times that it's 1 and sometimes it's 10. It is variable, but I would say more often than not, it's on the higher end of that scale. It is difficult to find placement on the inpatient side for someone that needs it as quickly as we would want to do it.
Inpatient beds are difficult for an adult population and really difficult for the youth and adolescents.
Two Rivers was one of the few psychiatric hospitals that took children as young as 5 years of age. The loss of that resource will hit them the hardest.
That's going to push more of the kids out into Crittenton and Children's Mercy Hospital and stuff like that, it may be other environments that they shouldn't be in.
Absolutely true.
Kyle Kessler is the executive director of the Association of Community Mental Health Centers of Kansas. The number of mental health beds for children has diminished from 800 in 2010 to just 350 in the state now.
So when you look at that and the waiting lists for psychiatric residential treatment facilities, that says two things to me. One, we probably haven't invested enough in outpatient services. And two, we've neglected our responsibilities of taking care of the kids in our communities in our state.
Kessler estimates the loss of 105 treatment slots from Two Rivers is well over 10% of the psychiatric beds in the Kansas City metro, a loss lacking outrage over the corroding mental health system.
And so if you told someone, hey, we're going to lose 10% of the oncology beds in our community, or 10% of the hospital beds for community hospitals, that would get their attention immediately. And so that should absolutely raise a red flag to policymakers, I think.
Dome and Pat, this also means that the jails will be flooded with people who should be getting help. Now, if you want your voice to be heard, call your legislators and demand funding for this most vulnerable population. Shannon O'Brien, Fox 4 News.